Hello everyone, this is the Daily Devotional video for October 15th, 2017. Our passage for today is in the book of 1 Peter chapter 2. We're reading verses 13 through 17. Therefore, submit yourselves to every ordinance of man for the Lord's sake, whether to the king as supreme or to governors as to those who are sent by him, for the punishment of evildoers and for the praise of those who do good. For this is the will of God, that by doing good you may put to silence the ignorance of foolish men, as free, yet not using your liberty as a cloak for vice, but as servants of God. Honor all people, love the brotherhood, fear God, honor the king. Title for today's devotional is Under God or Under What? God gave the people of Israel the Old Testament to instruct them and to offer the nation hope. The father's commands were designed not to ruin his children's fun, but rather to help them avoid harm. In Deuteronomy 8:19, we see that God holds believers accountable. He will bless and protect them. But if they turn away, they can expect his judgment. Were he to operate in any other way, he would be permissive and unreliable. But we can trust the Lord to do exactly what he says, because the Bible records that's just how he interacted with his beloved nation of Israel. In fact, Israel's history was a continuous cycle of blessing, waywardness, judgment, repentance, and blessing. If God deals with the, quote, apple of his eye this way, what can we expect? We can count on the Lord being true to his principles, no matter which country we call home. According to Romans 13, believers are to be respectful, responsible citizens because, quote, all authority comes from God, and those in positions of authority have been placed there by God, end quote. That's from verses 1 and 6 or 7. Those who observe his standards can anticipate blessing, just as repercussions await those who ignore biblical principles. The Lord is long-suffering, but if we deliberately ignore his guidance, we can expect to deal with the consequences. 2 Chronicles 7:14 encouraged believers of that day to humble themselves, pray, seek God's face, and turn from their wicked ways. We must do the same if we want God to hear from heaven and heal our lands. Wow. As long as you put your faith and trust in God and are obedient to what God wants you to do, God will bless you. But if you turn away from him and think you can do things on your own without God's help, you don't need God's help, you can do this on your own, or maybe you don't agree with what God wants you to do, so you do your own thing, God's not going to protect you from the consequences of your decision. So it's always best to do things God's way because he sees the whole picture. I love you guys so much. Have a blessed day, and I hope to see you back here again tomorrow.